Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Nikhil Kumar. If your Kubernetes cluster is using Ingress NGINX, so you need to hear this. The Kubernetes just announced the retirement of Ingress NGINX by the end of March 2026. After that, there is no updates, no bug fixing, and no security patches. So in this video, I will break down what's happening, why it's a big deal, and how to check if your system is being affected, and what are the migration options are. Let's take a quick step back and understand what exactly is Ingress NGINX and why does everyone uses it. Ingress is how we route external traffic into services running inside the Kubernetes. And for years, Ingress NGINX has been the default choice. It's flexible, open source, and not tied to any specific cloud provider. The flow is simple. A user hits your application. The request lands on the Ingress NGINX, which acts as a single entry point into your Kubernetes cluster. It then routes traffic based on the rules defined in your Ingress resources, forwarding the request to the correct service and finally to the pods running your application. It's simple, powerful, and everywhere, but it's also starting to show its age. Everything is defined under a single Ingress resource and it works really great until you try to scale across multiple environments, teams, or complex routing policy. That's why Kubernetes decided to take a modular and policy-driven approach and introduce the Gateway API. Before we jump into that, let's talk about why the Ingress NGINX is being retired. So Ingress NGINX has been launched in 2017, but the maintainers have been struggling for years with technical debt and the security concerns. For instance, the powerful feature allowing custom NGINX snippets, once seen as flexibility, is now a major security risk. And with only a handful of maintainers volunteering their time, and the project just couldn't keep up. So instead of leaving users exposed, they made a tough call, but responsible decision, to retire the project entirely. It's a tough call, but the right one for the long-term security. So what does this mean to you and your current Kubernetes cluster? Until March 2026, you will get the best efforts maintenance and minimal updates. After that, the GitHub repository will be a read-only mode. Your Kubernetes deployment won't suddenly break. But as the new Kubernetes version rolls out, you will start facing an issue with respect to the compatibility of the newer Kubernetes version, and the security vulnerabilities will start showing up. To check if your Kubernetes cluster is running with the Ingress NGINX, so you can run this command to quickly check if your cluster is currently using Ingress NGINX. But if you are having a RKE2 cluster, that is a Rancher Kubernetes, so then there will be high chances that it will come up with the Ingress NGINX by default. And if you want to check if Ingress NGINX is installed in your different Kubernetes flavor, then you can run the kubectl command with the selected tag and look for a Ingress-NGINX label. Now the big question is, what's next? What replaces Ingress NGINX? The Gateway API, the next evolution of Ingress for Kubernetes. The Gateway API brings a fresh architecture built for modern, multi-tenant Kubernetes environment. Instead of single monolithic Ingress resource, it breaks traffic management into modular and layered resources. Here, how it works, the gateway controller like APISIX, Istio, or Traefik provides the actual implementation. It uses a gateway class which defines the types of gateway. For example, internal or external. You can think of this as a template for gateways. Then comes the gateway itself. It's a real entry point for your Kubernetes cluster. It's your cluster front page. Finally, the route, like HTTP route, TCP route, or the TLS route, defines how the traffic is being handled and forwarded to the services. This layer model gives you a fine-grained control, role separation, and much cleaner security boundaries. Platform team can manage gateways, while developer focus on routes. It's safe, more modular, and better aligned with how large team actually operate. The Kubernetes team officially recommends migrating to Gateway API. That's the path forward. But if you're looking for something with advanced feature, like rate limiting, observability, and authentication, then tools like Apache API6, Kong, or HAProxy are also a great alternatives. The key takeaway is don't wait for 2026. Start testing your migration plan now. Even a small POC can help you catch issues early. Ingress NGINX has served Kubernetes world really well, and it powered billions of requests. But ecosystem is evolving, and it's time to move forward with Gateway API and next generation controllers. In my next video, we will get hands-on with the Gateway API, set it up from the scratch, deploy real routes, and map your existing Ingress config to the new Gateway API model. If you found this helpful, hit the like, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.